potluck lunch in the park. Meet at Lucy's, 1234 21st Avenue Northwest, Parkview Village. Bring a musical instrument. For more information, phone Virtual 403-230-7173. Prayer and fasting. First Sabbath of the month, special prayer service will be held after divine worship service. You are welcome to stay. Help Fund needs help. The Help Fund needs replenishing. If you are able to contribute to the church building fund as well, much appreciated.
Smile and be nice. Hey, good morning. Please be seated, everyone. Good morning, church. At this time, we're going to invite Kai Kai and his friends, and they're going to do a musical item for us. So please sit back and enjoy.
Each one of you.
Amen.
The children of traveling from the wilderness of sin and pitch and Rephidim. There was no water. The people were very thirsty. Then they chatted with Moses and said, "Why did you take us out of Egypt? Why did you take us out of Egypt to kill us and our children and our cattle with thirst?" And Moses said unto God, "What shall I do with these people? They are almost ready to stone me." And God said, "Take some of the elders in Israel with you, and I will stand within before the rock in Horeb, and you shall strike the rock." And Moses did that in the sight of the Lord, and there was water for the people to drink. Then the Amalekites wanted to fight some of the Israelites. So Moses said unto Joshua, "Go get some men so we can fight Amalek." And he did that. Then he stretched up his hand and the people prevailed. But when he put down his hand, Amalek prevailed.
Thank you.
that he built a bridge, yet for safety he became poor, so that you,
thank you. So I will ask all the parents to be patient with us as we took up the challenge with Jesus. It is no secret that God has been using children in the past, and God is still using children today. Amen, church?
Amen.
So I guess we can say that God is using the children of Cornerstone today. Doing the children's story. I prepared the whole week for the story and I was excited when Sabbath came, but due to lack of time, I didn't get to do it. I was promised that I would get another chance to do it, but that chance never came. I guess the Holy Spirit was speaking through Pastor Vassal, so I have the opportunity to come today. Amen, church? I am not angry, but sometimes God works in different ways. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this awesome and wonderful day today. I thank you for Children's Day, and I thank you for all of these children who are here today. And please help me and guide me and help me to speak your words in Jesus' name. Children suffer the most. Sometimes I wish that children maybe ask before a family breakup happens. As children grow up, there always seems to be pressure wherever they go. There's pressure at school, home, and yes, at church. At school, there's pressure to score the highest grades in subjects, mostly math. There's also pressure with friends, how they act how they dress a certain way, and yes, to own the latest electronic gadget. But some parents don't always get it. My hope is that this Sabbath, that all the children of Cornerstone may be rewarded with an iPhone or a fantastic job. Amen, parents? At home, there's pressure on doing chores and keeping our rooms clean, and always picking up after you play with your toys. Sometimes I ask myself, why can't I just be him? Why can't parents take care of all these things? Amen, church? At church, there's pressure with reading the Sabbath school lesson. There's also pressure with leading the worship service. They're both good things. And there's also pressure with waking up early in the morning. I have a question. Why is it so hard to come out of bed on the Sabbath? There is also a disconnection between what is being taught at school and what is being taught at church or home. At school teaches you that Christianity or religion is not an important factor for life and that success at school is more important. The Bible says that God always has control over our lives, and he is the one who decides whether we succeed or fail. At school, we are taught that we have control over our lives and we can make our own choices. But the Bible teaches us that we have no control. Jesus has control. The best choice that we can ever make as children is surrendering our lives to Jesus Christ. Is that right? Is that right? So who is right? Home or school? Discipline. What is discipline? The Canadian government says no spanking. Some parents here do agree, but a good number of parents here at church don't agree. So who's right? Please don't ask my parents what they think about discipline, or because I don't want to get in major trouble. Now, let's get into the word. Okay, the scripture that was we're going to go to the scripture that was taken in the morning. Deuteronomy 11, verse 19 says, "Teach them to your children. Talk about them when you sit at home, when you walk along the road, and when you lie down, and when you get up." Thank you, Bliss, for reading the scripture for us today. Here, church, the word is talking about loving the Lord and obeying his requirements, regulations, and commandments. The scripture reminds us that the parents, not the church, have the biggest role to play in teaching the children of the 21st century about God. Amen. Church. Our parents are to teach us about the way of God at home when we're traveling and when we go to bed and when we get up. Brothers and sisters, this means that whenever we do, our parents should be teaching us about the way of the Lord. The first thing that the children in the 21st century should hear when they get up is about the love of Jesus. And the last thing that they should hear about when they go to bed is about the love of Jesus. In other words, parents should be teaching their children about the knowledge of God and His loving words. Not once a week, but every day. Every opportunity they get with their children, they should talk about Jesus. The scripture did not say that the church or the village should be responsible for teaching the children. The scripture was very clear and says that the parents are the ones that have the primary responsibility of teaching, training, and mentoring their kids about the knowledge of God. But before parents can teach their children, Deuteronomy 11 verse 18 says that parents are to embrace the word wholeheartedly in all aspects of their lives. In other words, parents should read the word, know the word, and say, do what the word is saying before they can train their children. Children in the 21st century or more are no different from other children in different centuries. For example, parents. They are to lead exemplary lives to their children so children can look up to them. When children see good role models in their parents, it will be easier for them to have knowledge of God and also the love of God. But the problem is with children in the 21st century is that they spend most of their time at school, daycare, or day home. There was a survey that was taken about how much time that children spend with their parents at home. The survey says that mothers spend 14 hours a week with their children at home, and fathers spend about 6 hours a week at home with their children. By comparison, children spend an average of 40 hours a week at daycare, day home, or at school. In those 14 hours, how are we supposed to teach children about the love of God? 14 hours is just not enough time. How much time do you spend with your children? The Bible says in Judges 2 verse 10, it says that after a generation has died, another generation grew without knowledge of the Lord or remembering the mighty things that He's done for Israel. This is one of the most disappointing stories in the Bible. Instead of worshiping the one true God, they were worshiping false idols of other nations. If you continue reading the verse, the Bible says that the children of Israel provoked God to anger by worshiping idols. Why? Because their parents didn't teach them the knowledge of God and His loving ways. The same thing can happen again, or should I say, the same thing is happening with the children of the 21st century. The Bible says that God's anger was arose against Israel, and the result of Israel could not stand against their enemies. Brothers and sisters, if you don't teach the children of the 21st century about God, the church won't be there for the next century, for the next generation. As children, today we don't want God's anger to be aroused against our parents. God wants us to think about other generations after us. We're also supposed to think about our children's children. Parents, there is a danger. When we get too busy in our lives, we neglect to teach, mentor, and train the next generation. Proverbs 22 verse 6 says, train up the child in the way he should go, and when he is schooled, he shall not depart from it. My prayer today is that God will encourage us to read to our parents to teach, train, and mentor us for the love of God, and we can and talk about it for the future of the church. God bless you.
Amen.
De realidad. say, okay, we said that all the time. But I think I want to, on behalf of the leadership of the church, publicly thank Sister Benedict and company for the marvelous job that they are doing with the children. And what you see here today is the beginning, the embryonic stage of great things to come.
Amen.
I want to publicly thank her for leading the charge and all the others who have played their part. I'm going to ask the volunteers who work with the children's department to stand. All those who helped prepare the children for this day. All those who assisted Sister. Come on, Sister Koba. Come on, stand. She is so shy. So even if she doesn't stand, I'm going to be here. There she is. There they are. Please put your hands together. Thank you for listening. Probably we should take what Aaron said and give them a special. Electronic gadget. Yeah, but seriously speaking, I would want all parents who heard the message today to really let it soak. That little boy's message, let it soak. He spoke to parents. He did not speak to children today. He spoke to us as parents. And I would beg you, ask the Spirit, since you never recorded it, ask the Spirit to replay it so that you can hear it again. And I hope that we will see the impact of that message upon our performance, and it will be reflected in the children's display at church. They will only get better from here on if we take heed to the word. Thanks again very much, Sister Benny. Thanks, children. You did a very wonderful job. Parents, please put your hands together for the children. And with God, it will only get better from here. Just want to remind you that the choir members, we have a date. Sister Donna, what time is it?
6 o'clock.
Choir members are supposed to be at Bridge Line at 6 o'clock for practice. I'm going to ask all the men who should have turned up for practice Thursday but did not turn up to meet there all to go at 6. All right, thank you.
Thank you, Pastor Basil. Good afternoon, church.
I want to thank you for everyone who participated in the children's program. Thank you for the food, clothes, and shelter, and the wonderful Sabbath you've given us. Bless us and help us to continue to work for you, and take us in home, we pray, in Jesus' name, amen.